This is a weird ass Tootsie Pop rant. Goodness, Caleb, speak English. YOLO, everybody, it's the man, the myth, the legend, Quad MFT here, and I can tell you guys are already freaking out, like, OMG, what's going on with the gameplay, Quad? Like, why is it all sped up? Why is it all going really, really fast? Of course, I meant that by sped up, but I really wanted to say that I've been doing something recently in Call of Duty that kind of keeps Black Ops 2 alive for me, because we all know it's that time of year where Grand Theft Auto 5 starts to come out, Call of Duty Ghosts is starting to come out, we're really starting to learn quite a bit of information on Call of Duty Ghosts. A lot of people are like, oh, okay, I can see that. New game modes, perks, guns, all these different things that we're going to be really looking forward to. So I still like Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 is definitely a really good game, but I want to keep it entertaining. So I really do like to challenge myself. That's something that I've been doing a lot. And as you can see by this gameplay, I'm playing with a full 5-man party. I tweeted out, got quite a few subscribers, actually got a full team of subscribers, and I was playing with my dad and a few personal friends and friends that I know in real life. But what we were doing was we were giving the enemy team a 122-point comeback in Dom, where we would give them basically a free 122 points in domination and then try and come back and actually make the comeback and take the win. And we actually did do that, and we didn't win by a cheeky 1 point or anything like that. We actually won by quite a bit. So I consider 10 points to win by quite a bit, because I mean, think about it, guys, they didn't have one of our flags for like I'd say about 15 to 20 seconds for 10 points, but actually like 30 seconds for 5 to 10 points around there, around that situation. But the reason why I did this sort of specific gameplay, you know, trying to switch it up, is because the main fact that I wanted to tell you guys not to only challenge yourself in Call of Duty to keep the game alive. You know, recently I've been starting to live stream a lot on Twitch TV. You guys can go down in the description, follow my Twitch TV. I will be streaming tonight when you guys are probably watching this video when it comes out, but if you're not, then I actually am probably still streaming, so go over, check me out, link down in the description, follow my stream, hit me up on there. I do play with subscribers all the time, play Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 3, all these different games. And also, if you guys wouldn't mind liking this video for this epic comeback gameplay, I believe it pretty much deserved it. I worked really hard to get this gameplay. We actually probably played 6 or 7 games to get this. I mean, not 60 to 70. I meant to say 6 to 7. If it sounded like 60 to 70, that's way too much. That's a lot of Black Ops 2 games. I feel like I'd get really, really fed up really easily, but I do have a few other games saved like this where we got 100-point comebacks and 110-point comebacks. We kind of had to slowly work our way up to it, because it's kind of, in fact, it's really, really hard to just go straight to 122 points. In fact, we were going to go 125, but we didn't really want to push it. We didn't want to lose the whole game. I believe one of our people in our party was actually on a win streak or something like that, so I don't think we actually really wanted to mess with that, so we just waited till 122, because we all know we've all been in those games where 3 points can really make a difference. But I'm also here to tell you guys that actually, you know, challenge yourself in life. And I actually find myself being one of those people who are really prone to taking the easy way out, but not necessarily one of those people who's a big procrastinator. You know, maybe with schoolwork occasionally, you guys know, I'm sure a lot of my real life friends are watching this and be like, oh my gosh, Caleb, what are you talking about, dude? You always procrastinate with your schoolwork. But recently, ever since I've started the stream and really, you know, try really hard at YouTube and make sure I get everything done, I've been actually doing, in the past 2 or 3 days, I've been going really hard on my schoolwork. I've been getting it done right when I get home, trying to do my best in class, trying even harder tests, because, you know, I mean, of course it's nice to slack off when you're slacking off, but it always gives you that kind of like, ooh, I'm feeling a little bit stressful. I was out tonight. I don't know if I can come home and do my homework. I may have to do it in the morning or at lunch at school, because I found myself actually being prone to doing it in the morning and then my alarm not working or something, and something goes wrong and I have to go hard and actually do it all the time at school and during lunch and stuff like that. That's just, it's not a pleasant time. But I also say, you know, maybe if you guys are thinking about, should I retake, let's say, Algebra 2? Should I retake it and not go to trigonometry next year? You know, maybe if you need it, but why not challenge yourself? Why not try trigonometry? And you know, if trigonometry is not your thing, maybe you guys don't like trig or anything like that, maybe then you can just go straight back to Algebra 2, because you can always go back. You're not always stuck in trigonometry, I don't think, at least in high school from where I'm at, which is Northern California. I mean, either way, guys, I really think that just challenge yourself. You know, that's why I like to challenge myself by uploading every day, not missing a day. I haven't missed a day in such a long time, guys. It's not even funny. Trust me, I've been going so hard. I believe I almost have 200 videos in a row. It's probably actually around the 190 to 195 area, but I like to say 200 just to round it up. In the next, of course, the next 2 weeks, it'll probably be around 200. In fact, it will be around 200 because that'll be 14 days, and I won't miss a day. No matter what, guys, I always have new content up on my channel. That's one. That's definitely something that I really take pride in, is being really dedicated. Always good. I hear this a lot, that I have really good thumbnails, and I like to say thank you to all the people that think I'm talented in Photoshop. I think I'm really more talented, mainly just the thumbnail area, not just a specific type of thumbnail. I can do quite a bit of different ones. If people tell me to copy a certain one, then I can basically mirror that if you guys give me all the images and stuff like that. But sometimes I can even go out and find all those images on my own and try and mirror it my best. But most of my thumbnails are actually quite original ideas. You know, I have a few things stolen here and there. Just, you know, if you're stealing from me, think about this, guys. You're stealing twice, because I probably stole that from someone else. I mean, not in real life, not like money or anything. Well, maybe, but no, guys, I mean, well, that was a fake laugh. Maybe I did steal something. The world may never know. Do you know how many licks it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? No, you don't. That's what I thought, guys, turning this commentary into a twist. You didn't think this was coming, but do it. Go out, lick a Tootsie Pop. Lick it till you know how many takes it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop. Tell me, I want to know down in the comment section below, have you guys ever licked a Tootsie Pop so much that you guys know how many licks it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? Tell me, guys. I'm interested. I don't want to Google this. I don't want to go on Ask or Yahoo Ask or anything like that and figure it out by some eighth grader. Even though I am an eighth grader, or I was last year, but I want to know. I want to know from you guys. Maybe even if you guys are fourth grade, you guys probably know a lot more about Tootsie Pops than me. And this is a weird-ass Tootsie Pop rant. Goodness, Caleb. Speak English. I don't know, guys. I got off some weird tangent, and I think a demon took over me or something like that, but that's just weird, but I guess that's what you get. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this awesome gameplay. I clutched out on this. We got the win. Make sure to click like. 250 likes. Let's go for it. That's a really high goal. It's been QuantumFT. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit me up on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. All links down in the description below. It's been your boy QuantumFT, hopefully your favorite commentator, and I'll see you in the next video. Caught up in this dream world, getting used to life. Hanging with the wrong people can keep you from doing right. So I keep my circle tight, homie, you can never penetrate. If your mindset is just a hate, you should renovate. Do some mental feng shui, boy, I'm hella hungry. I never play it safe like a touch base. Listen up, fuck face, open your damn eyes. If ignorance is bliss, then they feeding you damn lies. I'm never giving bad vibes, homie, you just antsize. Always do it.